Replay is coming up next in Unscrewed with Martin Sargent at 11:30.
Today on X-Play, Sony and Sega and Square, oh my! We're turning Japanese at the Tokyo Game Show! How do you say more great games than you can shake a stick at in Japanese?
You are watching X-Play!
Thank you, Crazy Mushroom Lady!
Yay!
It's game time!
TGS. The TGS stands for the Tokyo Game Show, and it's a huge video game expo in Japan.
Yes, they have a theme this year. It's a brand new sensation for everyone in the world. Of course, they don't say what that sensation is, and as far as I can tell, it's loud.
It is loud in here. There's a lot of concrete, but we're here for the games and for the hardware.
Yes, of course, there's a brand new piece of hardware being shown up here, and that's Sony's PSP, and that's actually the actual size back there if you're a giant person.
Well, I'm gonna go to EA.
All right, you go to EA.
Yeah.
I'm gonna find out more about the new handheld.
Have fun.
Bye.
Okay, bye.
Well, here it is. This is the PSP's coming out party. It's no longer behind glass. It's now attached to women, who will not be available for the US version. Sorry. I can tell you a couple things right here. The screen is still beautiful, and the battery life is still mysterious. Sony has a lot of games on display, so let's go check them out.
The top draw here is Metal Gear Acid. MGA takes the trademark stealth action of the series and translates it to riveting card battle action. We also saw a ton of games we are excited about, like Coded Arms, Puyo Pop, Gran Turismo, Armored Core, Ape Escape, Dead Aggressor, and Lumines from the makers of Rez. And there are some games we are less excited about.
That game is Mahjong Fight Club. The first rule of Mahjong Fight Club is you don't talk about Mahjong Fight Club. The second rule of Mahjong Fight Club is you're not gonna be playing Mahjong Fight Club. Sony's big on the big things in the small packages. This is the PS2, TWO. It's a new reissued PS2 that is incredibly smaller and really cool looking. It's the same size as the controller. This game behind me is the happiest find here at the Tokyo Game Show. This is the follow-up to Ego. It's not exactly a sequel. It's a game that's made by the same people, and just by looking at it, you can tell it's from that team. In this game, you fight monsters to save the soul of a woman who has lost her soul. It does have a lot more action in it, but I have every reason to believe it'll still have the same beautiful emotional weight of the original Ego. Wait, what do you mean it's baseball? Alright, so these are the iToy games, and it's amazing. This peripheral has matured. I never thought it would happen. There's a DDR game. There's also a game from Sega called Sega Superstars. There's this game, which is Tecmo Sports. You can play baseball or boxing. And best of all, there's a game where you clean up someone's farts. I am not kidding. I can't believe it either. I can't believe it so much, you might as well pass it on to Morgan. She may not have flatulence, but it's probably something good.
EA in the States is huge, but here in Japan, it's just a tiny little corner of the market. But there is something that does appeal to the Japanese sensibilities, and that's Need for Speed Underground.
Hey, target demographic guy. If you like turning on your car more than your girlfriend, your game's coming. Need for Speed Underground 2 promises to up the ante in terms of car geekdom with more performance tweaks, racing options, and car types. You'll forget where your bedroom is entirely, with up to 200 kilometers of drivable game space. That's 124.27 miles, in case you were wondering. Need for Speed Underground Rivals for the PSP is its big brother's little counterpart and offers an astounding array of its bigger siblings' prowess. Nicely rendered environments and car physics make this an awesome diversion for driving hours away. Ready for the magic? Still not tired of talking trees and breath-challenging orcs? Lord of the Rings: The Third Age brings the wee folk of Middle-earth into the RPG realm with more visual incantation than you can shake an elven sword at. All your faves will be here, complete with their own special charms. The game promises depth for RPG fans, as well as a nice starting place for those new to the genre. You'll also get to be the bad guys, too. GoldenEye Rogue Agent lets evil shine as you can play against Bond as one of his nemesis. The tagline for this title is, "Why save the world when you can rule it?" With production designed by none other than original Bond film fella Sir Ken Adam, this game promises the devil and the details. Tiger may not currently occupy the greatest golfer status, but that doesn't mean he still won't sell more games than Vijay. Tiger Woods' PGA Tour for the PSP is packed with real golf AI and physics, and includes all of your favorite licensed little ball swatters. The graphics are amazing, and the membership dues are reduced to a one-time fee for the PSP.
Coming up, Sega's got some strange games, and Morgan takes on Capcom.
Brought to you by Mortal Kombat. It will consume you. Mortal Kombat Deception, now online.
It will summon you. It will challenge you. It will consume you. Mortal Kombat Deception. Online for PlayStation 2 and Xbox. Rated M for mature.
The real-world testing we do here at Honda's Safety Research Center enables us to design products that provide exceptional protection for drivers, passengers, and pedestrians. Because what we learn in here makes a difference out there.
Yeah, my brother-in-law, he's always inviting me over to watch his big, fancy TV.
And you hate him for it. So you want something bigger and better for a lot less money.
Yeah. I guess
you're just what I need. That's what I need. At Circuit City, we have all the hottest new TVs, from HD TV to plasma, LCD, and more. And with unbeatable prices guaranteed, you'll find the perfect one. Circuit City.
First there was pizza, and it was good. Then there was something entirely different. The new Double Melt Pizza from Domino's. Layer upon layer of cheese and
crust.
Excuse
me. Do we have to do this every time we order?
Why not?
Domino's new Double Melt Pizza. Layer upon layer of flavor. With a creamy blend of cheeses and herbs between two thin crusts. Buy your medium one-topping Double Melt Pizza for $9.99 and get any second medium for just $5 more. Get the door. It's Domino's new Double Melt Pizza.
You can handle a long, hard day, but can your deodorant? Yeah, it's Arm & Hammer Ultra Max with our clean feel formula for 24-hour protection. All day, all night. Guaranteed. Ultra Max deodorant. 24 hours of clean.
Yeah! Get some! Oh! Oh, God!
Feel the power of the new Nokia N-Gage QD from Singular. Insane graphics and the latest titles. Get yours at Singular Wireless, rated T for teens.
You found the G-spot. Unscrewed with Martin Sargent is coming up next.
Welcome back to X-Play at the Tokyo Game Show 2004. Now we're in front of the Sega Sammy booth, and there's a lot more games here than there were at E3. Now part of that reason is because a lot of these games aren't coming to the US. There's still some great stuff to check out, and some of it's pretty bizarre. Well, if you love old Francis Ford Coppola movies and Mickey Rourke, you should probably be excited about the Rumblefish, except it's not black and white and has nothing to do with the movie. Okay, I'm willing to stake my entire expanded cable career on the fact that this game behind me is not gonna come to the US. It's called Boys Love Attack. You know what? I would like to see this come to the US just to see the look on William Bennett's face.
Yeah, this is about as creepy as it looks. This is a DS game, and it's called I Will Die For You. I can't really figure out what it is, but it's like a dating sim where when I touch the girl, she reacts by giggling or crouching. I have no idea. But it is one of the few DS games we can find here. Now, it's interesting, we look at a video of it, and you see people playing it. The DS has been blurred out. We believe this because the DS has had a significant design change that probably was depicting the older version of it. To let it be known, there is no official Nintendo presence here, and that's why the DS has not been that prominent. All right, let's go see if things are a little less fuzzy over in Morgan's world while I make her giggle.
We're here at Capcom's booth to see Devil May Cry 3. Now, it's a little weird how bright it is in here considering how dark the game is. But now, we were a little disappointed by the second Devil May Cry, but we're hoping they're going to be able to turn it around for the third one.
With moves like these, Dante just might restore our faith. Slay gladiators and sneak through villas in Shadow of Rome for the PS2. Enjoy brutal combat, relax at the races, and prowl around an aqueduct in this action stealth title. Vampire Chronicle: The Chaos Tower for the PSP is a 2D fighter set in the Darkstalker universe. With 18 supernatural fighters to choose from, this game makes classic brawling portable.
I'm mad at you guys. Beautiful Joe was so good, and none of you bought it. But Capcom is not giving up on the series, and they're releasing Beautiful Joe 2.
Now you can play Joe's girlfriend, Sylvia, who kicks ass all by her lonesome. And the new VFX power, Replay, looks amazing. Killer 7 made a shadowy appearance at this year's show, but details were sparse. Expect dramatic visuals and a mix of first and third person gameplay. Whatever else Killer 7 has in store, when we know, you'll know. In the PS2 adventure Okami, you're a mystical wolf struggling to restore color to the world. Based on Japanese folklore, this striking title is unfortunately slated for a Japan-only release. The original horror adventure Demento casts you as a young woman trapped on a disturbing island with a monstrous thug after you. Your canine sidekick is sometimes Lassie to help solve puzzles, and sometimes Cujo to fight local freaks. We've saved the biggest for last, Resident Evil 4, or Biohazard 4 in Japan. Now, it's only for the GameCube. You're Special Agent Kennedy, charged with protecting the president's family. When the first daughter vanishes, instead of getting the firing you so richly deserve, you travel to a sinister European locale to find her. From what we can see, Capcom's work to reinvigorate the franchise has paid off. Murky woods, dark villages, and brooding castles will wrap you in the morbid embrace of palpable paranoia that only the undead, or Ted Kaczynski on furlough, can evoke. Capcom's mix of sequels and new properties makes for a strong lineup here in Tokyo. We're looking forward to giving the final games a spin.
Up next, Solid Snake, now in convenient travel size. Plus, what trade show would be complete without this?
Preview this Saturday. Check.
So what's the difference between Madden Football and blitz.
They all kick touchdowns.
These We Sell Everything stores don't take games seriously. You gotta talk to gamers.
Oh man, Blitz is like an arcade game. Helmets flying off, bodies piling up. Madden's more like being in a real game.
Sweet. Reserve the hottest new releases. Pre-owned games and equipment at big discounts. If you're serious about games, talk to the gamers at EB Games.
If you want to make tons of money on the internet, then you need a powerful website. Get your very own free website now that features over 50 ebooks ready to sell like hotcakes. Go to freebookwebsite.com now and instantly start selling the hottest ebooks like No Money Down Real Estate, Making Money on eBay, Golf, Internet Wealth, and many more. Over 200 million people online and $47 billion spent last year alone. Cash in on the high-profit electronic book explosion right now. Go to freebookwebsite.com and sign up free in total privacy. Guaranteed. No monthly cost ever. Get your free website instantly, right now. No waiting. It's all 100% totally automatic. There's no inventory to buy, no selling, no order taking, no customer service, no shipping, and no hidden costs. Go to freebookwebsite.com. We call it a cash machine on autopilot. But hurry before it's too late.
You found the G-spot. Unscrewed with Martin Sargent's next.
Welcome back to X Play. We're here at Namco's booth. Now, Namco is one of the oldest publishers in the business. In fact, they're celebrating their 50th anniversary this year. We're here to check out Ace Combat 5, which is the most popular flight game in the industry. Now, the team who's been doing Ace Combat 5 has been working on Star Fox for a while, but now they're finally getting back to making their own game. 30 missions, over 50 planes, and an all-new arcade mode are some of the goodies in this PS2-only title. Here's a game that needs no introduction. It's Tekken 5. Now, recently the series has lost a little bit of luster to Soul Calibur and Virtua Fighter, but they're hoping 5 will be the magic number.
Tekken 5 offers the largest collection of characters ever, including three new fighters. Raven, who reminds me of Blade. Asuka, who reminds me I need a haircut. And Fung, he reminds me why I dislike pain. A new graphics engine gives characters rich detail, and wrestling-style throws deepen the gameplay. Just remember, you need a PS2 to play it. In the spirit of TV spin-offs, Tekken's Nina stars in her own action game, Death by Degrees. Nina's familiar Tekken attacks, as well as new moves, will dispatch the bad guys, and her X-ray scan ability lets you target blows for grisly internal damage. Namco's sticking to well-known territory at this year's TGS, and so far the results look promising. We'll bring you more once these games are out.
Yep, wherever they're solid state, Konami is not far behind. This is the Konami booth and they printed out their old workhorse, Metal Gear Solid 3, once again. Give it up!
If you eat snakes, you are apparently a sneaky badass. Metal Gear Solid 3 Snake Eater brings back a taste for Snake and its expansive storyline. The Snake's back and slipperier than ever with the game's new trademark gore well on display, as well as stealth enhancement and improved enemy AI. If you're a big fan of Organ Loop, Nanobreaker promises an ocean-sized amount with which to slake your cruel gaming thirst. From the creepy folks who brought you Castlevania, Nanobreaker is a third-person hack and slash that ups the ante with some highly impressive graphic horror. Oh yeah, the developer says the crimson fluid is oil. Right. Remember Contra? Well, it was 17 years ago. Welcome to Neo Contra, which returns its 2D side-scrolling grandpappy into a 3D-esque world. Though having very little in common with think tank incubated world-dominating Republicans, you nonetheless have to kill everything in order to restore order. It's easy to die here, so make sure you wear clean underpants. Holy commuter cup-seeking King Arthur and his tin-clad comrades are back like a bull at a Renaissance fair. King Arthur is a hack-and-slash medieval mosh pit of a game where you'll be able to control heroes of the day,
And because we know our audience, we can't help but show you Rumble Roses.
Rumble Roses is a giggling grade school anatomy lesson where the digi-skanks beat the crap out of each other for your pleasure. The game includes 10 pissed-off broads of eye-fatiguing endowment who battle one another for personal improvement. 8 women will be known as faces, or good women of ill repute. And 2 will be heels, or really bad, bad girls. Do mean things, and eventually you'll unlock valuable content of wickedness for the girls you don't bring home to mama.
There's your look, but now let's move on to the thematically similar Tecmo booth and Miss Morgan Webb.
I'm here at Tecmo, and the only game they have really worth talking about is Dead or Alive Ultimate. Oh, and they just delayed it. Maybe they're trying to put a real fighting game in there.
But before we do that, this is Tecmo Sport for the iToy. Now with that out of the way, on to Dead or Alive. Online play is a massive force in the video game industry, and Dead or Alive Ultimate is the Tecmo answer to online fighting. Yeah! Physics engine is state-of-the-art, and the open environments are stunning. Okay, who am I kidding? For those of you who discovered the series with DOA Beach Volleyball, Dead or Alive has hot chicks fighting. There it is. You're probably surprised to learn that DOA Ultimate has male characters. Well, it does. So here's a look at Tecmo's opus of estrogenic combat. As I was saying, Dead or Alive Ultimate does have new environments, including the African Serengeti Plain, where you can mud wrestle. It still feels like Dead or Alive, but the combat is much improved. The online play works smoothly and adds an element of competition that is lacking in computer opponents.
K.O.
Aside from the game, Tecmo knows what their fans turn out for. What could that be?
Coming up, the Japanese love Square Enix and the Xbox. Well, Square Enix at least.
It's Fright Fest at Six Flags. Come out for ghosts, ghouls, and one screaming coaster after another. Get your discount tickets online at sixflags.com. Six Flags, it's playtime.
What happened in that house?
When someone dies in the grip of a powerful rage,
stop me!
A curse is born.
There's something else here.
And once it sees you, you can't escape the fury of the Grudge. The Grudge, rated PG-13. In theaters October 22nd.
Wow, that is clear.
With surround sound, this HD TV would be perfect for your party.
Yeah. Hey, you should come.
4th and 23. Williams rolls out, throws up a prayer. No!
That guy's on my fantasy football team. You know, you should think about TiVo. You can record the game and celebrate later.
Watch TV better at Best Buy. Thousands of possibilities. Get yours.
Really like to be a soldier?
What do you got?
I have a sit rep from Alpha Company.
Team ready to be verified. Verified.
Put yourself in the picture with this free video. You'll see over 200 great jobs in the Army and over 180 in the Army Reserve. You'll also see what skills you learn, how you can earn money for college, even what soldiers do in their free time. Call 1-800-984-ARMY now and get this free t-shirt and your free video. Put yourself in the picture and see what it's really like to become an Army of One.
Thank you.
Yeah, the Xbox in Japan are kind of like an Abbott and Costello sketch. They just don't seem to get each other. Behind me is an open multiplayer demo for Halo 2. The line is like 100 times shorter than what it was at E3. If you really wanted to play it, you should be coming over to Japan. You could just get on it in about 10 minutes. Nonetheless, there's nothing really new here at the Xbox booth, but we can go check in on some of our old familiars.
Yet another apocalyptic future is the setting for Phantom Dust. This third-person action game features psychic combat more than guns, although there's guns too, and pompadours. Mad Max lovers, watch for this one stateside. Rough city streets, dozens of rival thugs, and a license to kick ass. Sega continues the tradition of arcade-style beat-em-up games with Spike Out Battle Street. Forza Motorsport features highly customizable cars and fast racetracks, but the real standout feature is how hard it is. This racer demands real precision. It won't be a game you can pick up right away, but mastering the courses will satisfy even the most masochistic racing gamer.
Behind me is Conquer Live and Reloaded. Yes, it's a remake of a game. Yes, we saw it at E3, but we've never gotten to play your single player, and you can here. It's fun. It's like the old game, but the graphics have got to be seen to be believed. I've never seen anything look like this. This is one to be excited about. Come early 2005.
Hey, Daddy.
Now, behind me is a new game. It's called Metal Wolf Chaos. Now, get this. In the game, you play a mech who's fighting the U.S. military. And this apparently is going to be coming to the U.S. I have no idea how Tom Ridge feels about this, but apparently we need more threats in our world than just the average human. So look for this one whenever it shows up.
Not to be confused with Metal Wolf, Mecha Mech Action is back in Mech Assault 2 Lone Wolf. You start each match as a painfully vulnerable pilot and make a mad dash to your mech of choice. Gamers with a taste for danger can scale the side of an opponent and mech jack other players. This game is full of explosions too, just the way you like it. See, even the title explodes.
They say Xbox has an image problem in Japan.
We're here at Square Enix. Now, a lot of people would say that Final Fantasy VI is the best Final Fantasy. But being here, you wouldn't know it, because there are no less than three, count them, three spin-offs of Final Fantasy VII. Cloud wins.
The first spin-off is about as fun as it can get. Final Fantasy VII Advent Children isn't really a game at all. Set 2 years after Final Fantasy VII, fan favorite Cloud is soared deep in an exciting life as a delivery boy. So, as you might guess, his mundane life is turned upside down when he's asked to ensure the safety of a troubled warrior. Advent Children will be compatible with Sony's upcoming handheld, the PSP. The second Final Fantasy VII game to appear at Tokyo Game Show is Before Crisis. This cell phone game has already sold over 100,000 copies in Japan, but Square has no intention of bringing it to the States. Sorry. The last in this barrage of Final Fantasy VII-ness is called Dirge of Cerberus. This one takes place 1 year after Advent Children. Boy, they're really stretching out the timeline on Final Fantasy VII. Starring the undead Vincent, this game looks like more of an action game than an RPG. It's about time, Square. Kingdom Hearts 2 is turning out to be just what we expected. A perfect mashup of Disney and Square. Expect more bad guys, more Final Fantasy characters, and even more cameo appearances. Hopefully, improved gameplay will be included as well.
Loud day with the loudest thing we could find.
Yeah, we're so clever. All right, we have not seen that many new things here at the Tokyo Game Show, but one thing is very clear. The next 6 months in gaming are going to be incredible, possibly the best ever.
Yeah, we also learned a little Japanese. Budokai!
We have a new online game everyone is talking about.
Every weeknight, while you watch X-Play and Unscrewed with Martin Sargent, go online and play Hyperactive along with the shows.
You can win an iPod Mini and other cool stuff.
Many of you will be playing for months to come.
For rules and details, go to g4techtv.com/hyperactive and play along every night with X-Play at 11 and Unscrewed with Martin Sargent at 11:30.
You found the G-spot.